I'm not sure if it's just me, but riding a motorcycle gives you a sense of freedom. It makes you feel like you're in total control of the moment, that you're not just hanging, but flying through the air like there are no limits that can stop you. Now, with that being said, when you hear the word motorcycle, is the first word that comes to your mind Yamaha? Being the most famous motorcycle brand in the world, it should be. But did you know that this company didn't start as a motorcycle company, but originally manufactured pianos and reed organs? The founder of this brand was a man of good character with an unconstrained management style, who understood the value of raw materials and metalworking early on and was an engineer of exceptional zeal. Let's dive right in to learn more about his story. Genichi Kawakami was born on January 30th, 1912 in Hamakita, Japan. From a young age, he was always passionate about music, classical music to be specific. In fact, he would seize every opportunity he got to experience it. Fast forward a few years, when he graduated from Takachiho College of Commerce, his father was serving as president of Yamaha Corporation, a throne he would soon inherit as a fourth-generation president. He was an insightful marketing strategist and a visionary technological leader interested in Western classical music. So instead, Genichi initially worked in the musical instrument division at the Tenryu Factory Company for a couple of years. A few years later, in 1937, he joined a company known at the time as Nippon Gaki, a brand established by Torakusu Yamaha, an organ builder in the late 19th century. In 1950, he took over from his father and immediately set about expanding the business, which had produced its first upright piano in 1900, its first grand piano in 1902, and its first award-winning piano at the St. Louis World's Fair in 1904. Back then, people in Japan worked long hours for low pay during the post-war period, so only a few people outside of the upper crust considered Western classical music. Genichi, on the other hand, traveled to Europe and the United States in 1953, where he witnessed families engaging in recreational activities such as art and music. He assumed that Japan's growing middle class would be willing to follow suit. He didn't want to wait for the demand to grow naturally, so he helped establish the Yamaha Music School in 1954 that provided low-cost piano lessons, and franchises sprung up in other cities. He made sure that parents of students had the opportunity to explore Yamaha instruments. In 1954, only about 1% of Japanese households owned a piano. 40 years later, pianos were in close to 20% of households, and Yamaha became the world's largest piano maker. But that didn't stop Genichi. In 1959, the company created the Electone, an electric organ with special effects. He established the Yamaha Music Foundation in 1966, which hosted musical competitions both in Japan and abroad. Now moving on to the motorcycle journey, it wasn't until after World War II that Yamaha began manufacturing motorcycles. During the war, they built wooden aircraft propellers, but were soon forced to stop, expanding into metal models. Genichi modified the propeller lines for the 125cc Yamaha YA1 motorcycle in 1954. The elegant style of the AKA Tombo, also known as the Red Dragonfly, was quickly adopted by the Japanese market. I want to carry out trial manufacture of motorcycle engines. From these exact words spoken by Genichi in 1953, today's Yamaha Motor Company was born. The Yamaha Motor Company was founded in 1955, and it quickly expanded its product line to include boats, outboard motors, snowmobiles, water scooters, bathtubs, tennis rackets, golf carts, and machine tools. Both branches merged in 1987 to form the Yamaha Corporation. While the company was performing well and had some financial leeway, I felt the need to look for our next area of business. Demand is something we create, so I did some research. Genichi's pattern of innovation was based on his findings. He found the short Western bows more accurate during a trip with his son Hiroshi, a champion archer in high school. So he began making bows in 1959, and they quickly became popular. The organization even improved its ability to change processes. For example, the fiberglass technology used to make bows was adapted to make skis. He always did his research and would be ready to dive into a new field, believing he could. I learned many lessons and found two to be the most important. I would say you should always look ahead to the future. The research was one of my passions, so I always research to make business improvements. This need to always look ahead, combined with research, is how I developed the motorcycle division. He stepped down as Yamaha's president in 1977, but returned in 1980 because of a few family issues. Since handing over the presidency to his son in 1983, he remained Yamaha's supreme advisor. The company, which has expanded into semiconductors, industrial robots, and resorts, has had problems recently. Lower birth rates slowed musical merchandise sales, and Hiroshi Kawakami was forced to resign in 1992 due to a labor strife, ending three generations of the family reign of Yamaha. With his vision and philosophies, Genichi Kawakami paved the way for Yamaha Motor Company's growth. The company's total integrity with consumers and ability to create goods that stand on their own allows it to serve customers worldwide and enhance people's lives through high-quality, high-performance products. He passed away at the age of 90, leaving behind a legacy that is still highly valued in the industry. Yamaha employees worldwide continue to design, develop, engineer, and produce goods and services intended to offer customers, Kondo, a sense of emotion because of his clear vision and beliefs. If you enjoyed this video, consider hitting the like and subscribe buttons. It does wonders for the YouTube algorithm, so more people can see our videos and so that you can be notified when we launch our next video. We try and put out at least one new one per week, and as you can imagine, the research and editing alone of these type of videos takes us close to 18 hours. So we would really appreciate it if you could also check out our Patreon. For just $1 a month, you can support our work. We produce over 12 videos per month, so that is literally 8 cents per video. Thank you so much, and we'll see you at our next unmasking.